Hi guys, how's it going today? Great. First one up, my name is Joe, and my partner, his name is Trent, he's late.
No, I'm right here.
Trent, where were you?
I don't know. I'm sorry, I forgot.
How do you forget we had Y2?
I don't know.
Maybe we should have aligned our schedules together. Hi there, my name is Joe.
I'm Trent.
And there's our partner, you in the back.
Woo. Hi.
Can I get a show of hands? Who here plans meetings, hangouts, get-togethers with friends? So for everyone whose hand isn't up, don't worry, we can be friends, we can hang out sometime, all right? So, also by another show of hands, who here finds the process easy? Everyone's hand should be down. If they're up, you're lying, all right? No problem. So, let me guess. Your process probably sounds something like this. You should have a group conversation, trying to get something going, and then you start trying to schedule. The conversation goes back and forth, back and forth, and by the end of it, you still don't have the date or the time down, much less the location. This is truly a headache, and is something that no one should experience. Our solution is called Align. It helps you align your schedules together so you can plan a hangout stress-free. So in order to gauge the demographic of our audience, we decided to go out of the way and do some market research. We ended up consulting our competitors' data, showing that most of the people who use apps like Doodle are between the ages of 20 to 60. Obviously, this is a huge range. So we decided to narrow it to people between the ages of 20 to 30, because people around this age are more likely to plan hangouts, and also, they're more likely to adapt and use new products. We also pushed out a survey, and we got around 300 responses back. From the survey, we found out that 79% of people using Doodle or Google Calendar finds that it can be more efficient, along with the fact that 97% of people said that they have issues with finding a common time and dates and location that would work for everyone. As a result, we integrated this feedback into the design of our actual mobile solution. So here we have our first initial design. This is the homepage. The things that we focused mostly on is efficiency, clarity, and location service that sets us apart from our competitors. To start off, there is a nice calendar and a time that can easily be accessed. Choose what dates and time work for you. In addition, with the more options, you can also have the option of adding your ideal and not so ideal time. You may be free from Monday to Friday, but Wednesday works the best for you. Next, we have the location. We have a Google Maps integrated, along with the ability to vote for various locations to visit. There are some suggested locations, and this is one of our ad sources. These suggested locations work off of the proximity to the place that you already plan on visiting, along with the relevance to the office that you already have. Next, we focus on clarity by having these progress bars that easily shows which dates, time, and location are winning, along with ads at the back banner, and a nice information receipt page with the ability to easily share your results with other people.
We contacted over 100 businesses. Of those 100, half of them hung up and didn't say a single word to us. But of that half, 36 were very interested in our service and were giving us positive feedback on it. And then of that, a couple of them were actually so interested and wanted to be a future partner in the future, even though we had nothing to show them at that point. We just had to tell them about our concept. So, this is one of the business owners that we talked to, Angelo. He's a franchisee of a Second Cup location, and he said that he would love to be a partner in the future. So, I know what you're all thinking right now. This is amazing, I want this right now. But, you're probably wondering, how are we going to make any money? Well, we're going to have two revenue streams. Our primary revenue stream will be through direct ads from these businesses on our mobile solution. The other one will be through Google AdSense. So we found that when we talk to these businesses that would be interested in being partners in the future, that they'd be willing to pay around $1.50 per click that someone has on their ad. And then from there, we consulted web developers and marketing experts on these web pages to find that we get about 5,000 views on our web page per month. And 20% of those people would click on our ads, giving us that 1,000 clicks. So then we found that in total we get around $1,500 a month just from these direct ads, from people clicking on them. Then we also have the Google AdSense, which comes from the views on the web page. But since we are just starting off, we're not going to get very many views, so this number is not going to be very substantial.
Of course, with the actual Google AdSense, there is room for growth. When we're consulting with various professionals that have experience in monetizing web pages, they've projected us at a 10 to 15% growth rate based on our social media advertisement and organic growth strategies. In addition, I've also talked with a few entrepreneurs and business owners. One of them is Chris K, and Chris expressed interest in the idea and actually considered us as a premium service in the future once our app is developed. I also talked with Mohammed, who works at SkyTech Solutions. He was actually interested in integrating our system with his scheduling board in order to have more efficient meeting scheduling system. This shows that there is a large room for growth in order to grow our product. And in the future, we can consider a premium model service without any ads and additional add-on features as a method of advertising. Here is the team. Thank you very much for listening. We're open to any questions.
Assumptions around advertising.
Yes, definitely.
So, I guess, based on your financial projections, be it either an ad-supported service or a potential premium service, help us understand what you need to do in the next 12 months in order to drive scale. In other words, how are people going to hear about you? And help me better understand and help the rest of the judges understand. You're a young company, you're just going to get started. You've got two potential revenue streams. Most people would say you can only do one thing very well. So help us understand which of the two revenue streams you're going to focus on, and based on that, how you're going to grow your business, be it either to profitability or to where you want to be in a year. Pick whatever you want.
Sure, definitely. That's a great question to ask, and I have some insights regarding this. In order, in terms of which revenue model I'll have to go for, whether it's a premium service or the direct advertising ad with Google AdSense, I would like to go the ads method. This is because in the initial buildup of our product, there is going to be more users that are focused towards the casual hangouts, and therefore we are not entering the professional scenes yet. Initially, I actually planned on having this idea pushed towards a more professional audience. But after extensive research, I realized that there is actually a lot of various companies and businesses that already push a meeting system, and they can push it better than we can, as the meeting system is often integrated with other email and company planning softwares. If we were to get into a premium model, this would solely be based on the meetings itself. Would also like to consider yes.
So for the advertising. Help us understand what your target is in 1 year and how you're going to get there. So in a year's time, how many people are going to be using your product on a monthly basis, and tell us the steps that you're going to do in order to get there.
Okay.
So the first question is a number, and the second is tell us how you're going to get there.
All right, sure. So I would project around 10,000 users after our initial year, after the startup launch. We plan on getting there through social media advertisements, both organic and through ads on Facebook and Instagram. We decided to choose Facebook and Instagram as our main methods of advertisement, as Facebook is the largest social media platform, and Instagram is the easiest one to quickly grow any business idea with. With organic, we plan on spending around $40 a month to have people, in order to promote our Instagram page and have people like our content. We plan on using methods such as engagement groups, hashtag optimizers, along with an automated comment and feedback system to increase our engagement and get us out in the algorithm for Instagram. And with Facebook and Instagram ads, we plan on targeting people between the ages of 20 to 30 and using the information on their Facebook regarding how often they go out and hang out with friends. We'll target those who go out the most as they're more likely to schedule more meetings and have more hangouts.